Greetings to everyone. The title of my research topic will be David Ucebell Learning Theory, together with short biography, David Ucebell Meaningful Learning Theory, David Ucebell Subsumption Theory, and David Ucebell Advanced Organizer Model. David Ucebell, 1918 to 2008, short biography. David Paul Ucebell was an American educator, cognitive psychologist, and researcher who worked in areas in the field of learning and ethnic psychology. He was born in 1918 in Brooklyn, New York. In 1939, he studied a bachelor's degree in psychology at the University of Pennsylvania, where he graduated with honors. In 1943, he graduated from medical school at Middlesex University. In 1950, Ucebell earned his MA and PhD with a course of developmental psychology from Columbia University. He became the head of the Department of Educational Research at the University of Illinois. He also became the director of the Department of Educational Psychology for Graduate Studies at New York University. He was influenced by the teachings of Jean Piaget. He believed that an understanding of ideas, concepts, and principles is achieved through deductive reasoning. Ucebell and his wife has two children. He published more than 150 textbooks at several universities. Ucebell, in 1973, retired from academic life and devoted himself in his psychiatric practice. From the American Psychological Association, he received the Thorndike Award for Distinguished Psychological Contributions to Education in 1976. In 1994, at age 75, he retired from professional life to devote himself to full-time writing. He died on 2008 July at the age of 89. First topic will be David Ucebell Learning Theory. David Ucebell was a cognitive learning theorist who pay attention on the learning of school subjects and focus on what students already knows as being the main deciding factor what they learn next. Cognitive means intellectual activity that involves thinking. David Ucebell focused on the learning of college students. He believed that what a student already knows was the main indicator of what he/she would learn later. For him, learning by discovery was not advantageous. He claimed that all kinds of learning occur in the same way. He was influenced by the works of Jean Piaget. His theories were particularly relevant to educators. His work were focused on verbal learning. Verbal learning used words such as writing, reading, speaking, and listening. Verbal learning also involved language, speak, and use tools. Tools like pictures, symbols, figures, sounds, and others. He highlighted that we learn by constructing a network of concepts and adding to them. Before teaching new mathematical concept, the instructor should relate the new concept with pre-existed knowledge. For example, to teach length, width, height or distance, review first your students on units of measurement, such as feet, inches, centimeter, kilometers, and others. The next topic will be David Usabel Meaningful Learning Theory. David Usabel affirmed that understanding ideas, concepts, and principles were attained through deductive reasoning. This reasoning is a top-down approach from general to specific conclusions. Example of this approach from general. So, all dogs have tails. All flowers have leaves. From general to specific, you can have this example. Red meat has iron in it, and beef is a red meat. Dictionaries usually define learning as the process of gaining new understanding, skills, knowledge, and values. People can do it by themselves, but made easier with education. Over the years, learning is a term that had been studied in the field of psychology and education. One of the several types of learning was the meaningful learning based on the theory of meaningful learning by David Usabel. During the 1960s, the term meaningful learning was developed. It differs from rote learning. Rote learning is a method in which information is memorized and sometimes without elements of understanding. Example of this rote learning is memorizing the alphabet and in math. Times table and multiplication charts are often learned through memorization. The cognitive structure or mental process in meaningful learning is the key concept of Usabel theory. Usabel stated that we form the meaning when we bring something new to our cognitive structure and connecting it to the existing knowledge. Built on prior knowledge, meaningful learning becomes the basis for learning additional facts. Usabel emphasized that to learn meaningfully, a person must relate new knowledge to pertinent concepts they already know. Furthermore, Usabel analyzed that since meaningful learning involves a recognition of links between concepts, it has the advantage of being transmitted to long-term memory. According to Usabel, the learning can be meaningful if persons have relevant content in their existing cognitive structure that the new materials can be connected to. This type of learning stays with students for life since meaningful is constructive and allows students to be fully engaged in the learning process. Next topic will be David Usabel Subsumption Theory. Subsumption pertains to how a person acquired and learned large bands of information through text and visual means. The two types of subsumption theory suggested by David Usabel were letter A, derivative subsumption, and letter B, correlative subsumption. Derivative subsumption by Usabel is said to be a new concept that you have learned before and can be linked with other concepts, while correlative subsumption as a new concept learned is an extension of previously learned information. To give an example of each, for derivative subsumption, your concept of a dog is that he has four legs, two eyes, two ears, a mouth, a nose, a tail, and barks, and has a sharp teeth. Your concept of a dog, without altering it, is attached to your knowledge about Dalmatian dog. For correlative subsumption, example, you are looking for a new type of dog. To accommodate this new information, you need to include the concept of your Dalmatian dog to your previous concept of a dog. Another difference between derivative subsumption and correlative subsumption. Derivative subsumption is a new concept you already learned before. And correlative subsumption is when you add details to what you already know. According to Usabel, the key principle of his theory is that students should be presented with the most general concept first, and then their analysis. Example of general concept, cat, tree, fish. Then from general concept, their analysis. For example, for a fish, to analyze it, fish has gills, has pair of fins, and has scales that cover their bodies. My last topic will be David Usabel Advanced Organizer Model. To strengthen the cognitive structures of students, David Usabel designed the Advanced Organizer Model. Usabel believed that any subject is a chain of concepts and it is related to the old one. He pointed out that the model has advantage. He revealed that abstract subjects which can't be presented can be easily taught by this model. Usabel model helped to present the subject in organized way, and learners may get all matter in less time and in systematic order. Usabel felt that this model will help students organize information by connecting it to a larger cognitive structure. A tool that connects the familiar to the unknown frameworks for helping students understand what is it they'll be learning. For example, the teacher might discuss the origin of war before describing the major battles. To apply the model, first clarify the aims of the lesson. Present the learning material in logical manner, and the teacher can ask students to summarize, give new examples, or point out the difference and similarities. Advanced organizers are not simple overviews, but it presents a higher level of abstraction. Examples of organizer. You describe the new content. How do you describe a new content? Say, marbles inside a jar. Another example is skimming. Skimming material can be a powerful organizer. You present the main or general ideas first. Another example of advanced organizer is graphic organizer. Usually, you have concept maps and Venn diagram. What are concept maps? Concept map is a diagram or graphical tool that depicts ideas as boxes, circles, and other shapes that represent relationships between ideas and concepts. How about Venn diagram? You encounter Venn diagram in math usually. It is used to teach elementary set theory. Usually uses overlapping circles or other shapes, highlighting how items are different or similar. Okay, so that ends up my research PowerPoint presentation. Thank you for your time and have a wonderful day.